I'm Ritika Rai Bhattacharya. In the last video, we discussed about the introduction of the cell, about its discovery, about the unicellular and multicellular organisms. In this video today, we are going to discuss the cell makeup, means what are those components with the help of which the cell is made up of. So let's start with this. We know that the cells contain cell organelles in it. Cell organelles are many in number, but all the cell organelles are not present in all the types of cells. But there are few components which are common in each and every types of cells: cytoplasm, cell membrane, and nucleus. These are common in all the types of cells. We will discuss them one by one. The first is cytoplasm. As the name indicates, cyto means cell, plasm means fluid. So you know, this fluid which is present inside the cell but outer to the nucleus and inner to the cell membrane is known as cytoplasm. This is a jelly-like substance which keeps the cell hydrated. It is helpful in maintaining the proper shape of the cell. Right, the cytoplasm acts as a medium for all the cell organelles to float. Right, so you know here different types of cell organelles are present. So these organelles get the medium to float in the cell. The next point is cell membrane. This outer covering is known as a cell membrane. As the name indicates, it is membrane. It is forming a layer outside the cell. It is protective in nature and it also helps in keeping the cell in intact position or in proper shape. The another name of cell membrane is plasma membrane and plasma lemma. This cell membrane is selectively permeable in nature. Selectively permeable means it allows only the useful components to enter into the cell and doesn't allow any harmful component to enter. We have discussed about diffusion before also, that diffusion is the process through which the gaseous exchange takes place. Where the concentration of the gases is high, the particles will start moving from high to lower concentration. For example, here the concentration of a particular particle is more, it will move to those places where the concentration of the same particles is less. So diffusion helps in the transfer of gaseous particles. For example, if there has to be movement of oxygen and CO2, they will move with the help of diffusion into the cell. Right? But how the fluids will enter, that we will discuss in osmosis process. Osmosis is the process in which the particles of water move from region of their high concentration to low concentration. We will see if a plant cell or an animal cell is kept in a solution, what will happen. Three types of solutions we will take. This solution is made using water and sugar. We can also add salt instead of sugar. In first solution, the concentration of water is high and sugar concentration is low. In this one, water is less and sugar is more. In last one, water and sugar concentration are kept equal or same. If we keep an animal cell or a plant cell in this solution, we will see that there will be transfer of water particles from this solution into the cell because the concentration of water particles is more in the solution as compared to the cell. Whereas in this one, the water particles are less, So there will be transfer of particles of water from the cell to the outside environment. And in this one, the concentration of water inside the cell and outside the cell is same. So there will be no change, there will be no particle movement in the last solution. Now, when you see in this one, the water particles are getting entered into the cell. The cell will swell up. In this one, when the cell is losing water particles, it will become flaccid or it will shrink. Here, there will be no change observed. This type of solution in which water particles are more, we call them as hypotonic solution. In this one, in which the water particles are less and the solute particles, sugar or salt particles, are more, this type of solution is known as hypertonic solution. In last one, in which the water and sugar concentration both are same, this type of solution is known as isotonic solution. The last component which is common in all the cells is nucleus. The parts of the nucleus that we are going to discuss here are nuclear pore, nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm, chromosome, and nucleolus. Now, we will see a structure of nucleus. The nucleus is present at the center of the cell. Nucleus was first of all discovered by Robert Brown. Now, you see here the pores are present. These pores or the openings are known as nuclear pore. These openings help in the exchange of material from inside to outside. The entry and exit of the particles are controlled by these nuclear pores. Then nuclear membrane. This outer membrane is known as nuclear membrane. The nuclear membrane, as you are able to see, is present outside the nucleus. It will help in controlling the shape of the nucleus and also in protecting the nucleus from outside environment. Then nucleoplasm is present, which is the jelly-like substance present inside the nucleus. Nucleolus is the round structure which is present inside the nucleus. Nucleolus helps in cell division. We should never get confused with these two terms, nucleolus and nucleus. Nucleolus is present inside the nucleus and nucleus is present inside the cell. The chromosome is present inside the nucleus. If you uncoil this structure, you will be able to see a structure like this. Now, why first of all this is coiled structure? This is actually DNA which is coiled to form a structure that is known as chromosome. This coiled structure is present so that it can increase the surface area. The DNA is helpful in transfer of genetic material from the parents to the offspring. This one portion is known as a gene which encodes for a particular character or also more than one character. If you see the characters like color of the hair, color of eyes, our skin complexion, height, weight, all of these characters are encoded by a particular gene. The exact length of DNA is around 2 meters. That is why it cannot be present in such a tiny structure. That is why it is present in such a coiled structure so that it is able to occupy less space but increase the surface area. If you have seen the structure of bacteria, you will be able to see that the chromatin fiber, which later on forms the chromosome, is present in this manner at the center. But there is no outer covering of the chromosome because the nuclear membrane is not present in the bacteria. On the basis of presence and absence of nuclear membrane, there are organisms which are of two types, prokaryote and eukaryotes. Pro means primitive and karyote means nucleus. When the nucleus is of primitive type, in which all the cell organelles are not well defined and there is no nuclear membrane around the nucleus, those organisms are known as prokaryotic organisms. Then eukaryotes, eu means true. So in these organisms, a true type of nucleus is present. It means the chromosome is bound by a nuclear membrane and all other cell organelles are also well defined and well modified. That is why they are termed as eukaryotic organisms. Human beings, animals are all eukaryotic organisms. Bacteria are prokaryotes. This was about the components which are common in all the cells. In our next video, we will be discussing about some of the cell organelles. If you feel that this video is going to be helpful for you, please let me know in the comment section. Thanks for watching the video, and if you have not subscribed to this channel, please subscribe. Thank you.